Hey everyone, Joe here. Just doing an update on our cancer awareness group build hosted by Bob Buskin, which I failed to mention in the first video. Bob, apologies. But here's what we got going on. We are building the MPC 1970 Dodge Coronet. Y'all know me in MPC, and I do not hesitate to disparage them at any given opportunity. I know that there's others out there that love them. I know Matt over at the model car videos. You know, he makes good points. I just seem to not care for MPC that much. However, having said that, this is actually a really good kit. And I can't believe I'm saying that. I looked it up on ScaleMate because everything's been going together so well. There's no flash. The fit is very nice. Not perfect, but nice. On par with, you know, a normal regular kit. So I looked it up, and this mold is actually from the late 60s, 69, I believe it was. Even though this is a 70, I understand. But then this is the same mold that has popped the Pro Street version of this that others have built. It turned into the Dirty Donnie Pro Street version. Like, this is the only known. This mold is like the only 1970 Dodge Coronet out there. AMT's using it. And I'm sure that's mistaken. I'm sure there's others. But this is a very old mold. And it's been kept well. Let's put it that way. So here's what we got so far. Lots done. Very basic, though. Everything's very, very basic. That's how I am with cars nowadays, so just keep that in mind. We have our chassis. We use the Ushi powder on the tank. We use the light gunmetal gray on the exhaust, which we stole from our friend BG. We've got our 440 engine. Again, very, very basic. Didn't even really weather it up. Just kind of put it together. Putting in the radiator hose has actually made a rare occurrence in one of my builds. So that's good. I could probably stand to go in and dirty it up a little bit. If you know anything about Mopars, then you can probably tell from the engine bay where we're going. We have our interior done. Probably not really getting too good lighting on here. Pistol grip shifter. Sidewall interior, non-existent. So, or detail. Just, it's just not there. 1960 mold. I tried to do, one thing I won't do anymore on cars, and it might work on other kits, but I tried to do an oil wash just to make some of the detail pops a little bit, like I would do on a military build, you know? It doesn't work out so well. It doesn't, there's nothing really to cling to on this. Like, these are just not raised enough to do anything. So, yeah, it's flocked. I mean, it's, again, basic interior build for this. We did use a flat varnish on the seats and everything to make it look like cloth. And then we have our dashboard. Wood grained as best we can, same with the center console. I haven't used that technique in so long. It's been tough to get used to again. Top is shiny because it's going to be like a vinyl. And then, or semi-gloss, I should say, so like a vinyl. And then bottom is kind of a matte. But gauges from Best Model Car Parts on eBay. Still need to blacken out that grill right there a little bit. But, eh, not too bad. We're going to glue this in here. The one thing I don't like about these kits is, I mean, the steering wheel sits on the seat. And, you know, I'm not a big guy, but pretty sure the steering wheels in cars don't sit on the seats. Mine doesn't. And I have to use the telescopic thing in mine. We de-chromed the bumpers and re-chromed them. That is not going to come out well on camera because it looks gray. Hopefully when we do the different final shot, it's a different angle, different lighting, it'll be better. The back piece is aluminum. I wanted to be able to get the red stripes all the way around it, but that's not going to happen. And for now, that's all we got. So we'll come back with a final on this one because we're moving right along. We're zipping it all up. I'm telling you, this methodology that I've gotten of, you know, getting my parts ready, putting them together, and then kind of going through them that way. And also, I keep it simple. Obviously, I don't wire the engines or do anything fancy. Really makes things move along. So that'll be good. And then I can also say that I'll have a final coming up on Veronica's tribute build as well as Bella's tribute build. So lots of stuff done and accomplished. But this one's for the cancer awareness. Again, Bob, thank you very much for hosting. And until next time, take care.